The Lord Mayor has ramped up his push for Brisbane Metro, today releasing new figures proving the project's viability. But with a massive funding shortfall, its future will still rely on state and federal politicians finding the cash.
It's not a bus nor a train. It's council's answer to our transport problems.
Causing congestion, queuing and lengthy delays.
And with Brisbane Metro's price tag just short of $1 billion...
This project is affordable and doable.
Proven by its business case, according to the Lord Mayor, claiming that for nearly every dollar spent, the project returns nearly $2 in benefits, all aimed at easing road congestion.
Removes around 125 buses from the CBD.
Replacing many of them with these metro vehicles that hold up to 150 people and operate around the clock on weekends.
Turn up and within 3 minutes or even less, there'll be a metro service arriving.
The first metro line links 8 Mile Plains to Roma Street, while the second connects the Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital to the University of Queensland.
People will choose to use this instead of driving. That only eases congestion on our roads in the years ahead.
But it all comes down to cost. Councils say they can fund 2/3 of the project, but that still leaves a shortfall of more than $300 million.
Well, we haven't discussed the cost-benefit analysis with the state yet. They have now a copy of this document.
And say they'll be reviewing it, although...
You must realise this government's number one priority is still Cross River Rail.
Ben Murphy, 7 News.